Hi, this is Jeff, and let's review some of the questions on this exam. Let's start with number one, create an 8.5 by 11 landscape Adobe Illustrator document with two layers titled background and shapes. File new. And since it's 8.5 by 12, we can go basic RGB. I didn't specify what color mode. And then units, since I asked inches, switch this to inches. And here we go. 8.12. Hit OK. And the second question, create an object on the shapes layer. Oop, jumping ahead. I've got a two layers titled background and shapes. So let me go back to that. Here's the layers palette, and I'm going to move this in position so you could better see it. Just reduce the size of that palette. I'm going to just use BG for short for my background. And then let's just go back to other document, new layer, title of shapes. Okay. Let's create an object on the shapes layer with the pen tool that has four corner anchor points and is a complete path. Go to the pen tool. And I'm going to change the color just so you'll be able to see this more clearly. So it has this red fill and a black stroke. And I'm going to hover over the first anchor point actually, and click to complete the path. You can see the little circle symbol is next to the pen tool that indicates this is going to be a complete path. And I'm going to repeat this. So it's a simple click. There is no click and drag. Move my mouse, click release, move my mouse, click release. Move my mouse, go over the original or the very first anchor point that was created, hover over it, and then click once. It's a complete path. That's very different than click, 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 click. And I'm going to demonstrate the strokes on these by increasing the stroke width. And you'll see that's missing a stroke on the left side of the very top rectangle. That's not a complete path. All right, let's keep going on here. Create an object on the shapes layer with the pen tool that has four smooth anchor points. Let's make a little room, shall we? Back to the pen tool. I want to click and drag. By dragging, I'm creating a handle and a curve. I'm going to move my mouse, click and drag, release. I'm going to move my mouse again, click and drag, release. Click and drag, release. And then here, I'm going to hover over it, click and drag to the right. It may seem a little counterintuitive, but that's what you do. And release. And I'll go to the white arrow, the direct selection tool. And you can see we we have handles here, here, on, so there's two handles on each anchor point, which creates that smooth path. So let's create a compound path. There we go. So here we have this little rectangle on top of our semicircular object. Select both objects, go to Object, Compound Path, Make. I'm going to change the color of this so you can better see what's happening. And I want to move it back here. Get rid of that stroke. Basically, to create a compound path, you select two objects, and it's going to punch a hole in that object. Okay, let's go on. Create a 5x6 portrait Photoshop document at 200 pixels per inch with a CMYK color mode. Portrait is the key word here. Remember, there's landscape and portrait. Portrait is taller than it is wide. Landscape's just the opposite. So let's go to Photoshop. File, New. And here I'm just going to go to print, actually. This paper. Oh, it's RGB. Doesn't look right. Change to CMYK, right? That's the color mode I asked. 5x6. And I think I wanted 200, was that right? And let's hit OK. And we can click here and check what we have here. 5x6 inches, same way color mode, resolution 200 pixels per inch. Let's go back to Illustrator and see if those are the correct stats. PPI, correct. Okay. Let's move on. Create a clipping path in Adobe Illustrator. Demonstrate it with objects that are clipped. Let's go back. Okay, I'm going to utilize these shapes I have here to create that clipping path. A clipping path is different from a compound path. I'm just going to create an irregular shape to demonstrate this. Now, this path, an object that I just created, has attributes. One is the black stroke and that reddish fill. Once you utilize a path as a clipping mask, those attributes disappear. So I'm going to select all of these. Notice that they are behind, very important, they are behind this object, which is going to be the clipping mask. I'm going to remove the stroke on this and change the fill just to remove any confusion. Okay. Now let's select everything. Go up to Object, clipping mask make. And you could see that it's hiding, not deleting, hiding any imagery that's outside that clipping mask. I'm going to select one of the anchor points on this clipping mask. Now, if I move all of these anchor points outside, not that one, here we go. Well, I'll be able to see the whole thing. Right? So, and of course, we'll just get that out of the way. Now you can see everything and hiding that section. So it's a mask. Draw an asymmetrical composition using rectangles. Let's make some room here, shall we? So just for contrast purposes, let's just randomly place all these. Whoa, hey, what happened there? Now you could call this an asymmetrical composition. It's not the strongest composition, but it is asymmetrical. Now what happens if I align these? It's no longer asymmetrical. It has a central axis. This would be formal symmetry. Okay, let's wrap it up and good luck on your test. And after reviewing my tutorial, I realized that I created a portrait mode in Adobe Illustrator and not landscape. So if you're confused, you ought to be. So how do we switch that around? It's pretty easy. Well, can't see my toolbox right now, so let's move it over. And let's just go to the artboard tool right here. Double click it. And orientation. It's that easy. Click. And hit OK. And there you have it. It's a landscape. To get out of this mode, just go to your move tool, or just the, actually, I call it the black arrow and the white arrow. Simpler that way. And just click anywhere in the background and you're good to go. Thanks.